Hello everyone and welcome back. I'm Brad and this is World of Warcraft Legion. I'm on my warrior and we are in Highmountain. I'm doing world quests and I want to see just how many I can get done in 30 minutes. So there's a whole crap load of world quests all on the south side of the zone. And I'm just starting with killing harpies and dealing with the beasts
harpies
that they've
the
corrupted.
Are unleashing their perverse magic.
I am out of breath.
The screeching crash. We don't know how to counter their curses.
It is too far away.
Stop this madness!
Oh, crap. Did not see him coming. I can really hear my footfalls. Looks like there's one other player here that's doing this as well, and he's cleared the way for some of the items for me. All right, so now I just need two more harpies and one more wildlife slain, or two slain.
It is too far away.
The headbutt of the moose here, the elder horns, they may not do a lot of damage, but they can push you into other enemies, which could seriously cause problems. If you're already low in health and they're about to hit you with their horns, they could knock you into a bunch more enemies that can end up killing you. The funny thing is that, let's see, there's one harpy there, but I gotta also tackle. Oh, I mean, I never did do this quest. I might as well just tag it on.
What has the wind brought?
Quest log's full. I got too many quests. Go figure. Let's see. What can I get rid of? I could probably get rid of engineering. For now, anyway.
Greetings, traveler.
Quest log still full. Did engineering quest not count? I'll deal with it later. I figured since I was already doing this, I could just stack up and do it together.
Target.
One more harpy. Yeah, one more harpy, and this world quest is done.
The harpies of these mountains lost any respect they had for life. Now they practice their dark rituals, no matter who it hurts.
Okay, now we're gonna go after Sekhan. I think that's how you pronounce it. And he's just a large cat, I believe. Or if it might be the bear. No, I think it's the cat. So we're gonna cut through the mountain here. Should be right here.
To this world, but we cannot be everywhere.
Gotta wait for him to spawn.
We offer you the honor of taking down a grave threat.
You're too far away.
If this takes too long, we'll fade out and fade back in. Aha! There he is.
I need to get closer. Oh. Out of range. It is too far away. I am out of range. I need to be closer.
Get your aid this day, champion. The wardens are in your debt.
Okay, now we have to save some crops. Get rid of outgrowth, all that stuff. Which is right over here. Why doesn't it target my nearest guy? So annoying.
I am out of range.
Ah!
closer. It is too hard.
Six more grubs, and one more overgrown larva.
I am out of range.
Wow, people are just destroying the larva so quick. He usually summons a whole bunch of larvae, but he's also a quest NPC over here. So I don't want to attack him if somebody else needs to kill him. I think most players on our server already have their characters max level now anyway, but you never know if somebody's leveling someone up. I want to avoid it.
To bend.
That's good. I need two more.
I am out of range.
Done. What else is there? Mana saber riding. The mana saber riding in this instance in Highmountain is all downhill. It's not that you get hurt going downhill. But it is tricky trying to make sure you land all the spots. Because if you drop off the wrong hill, you gotta turn around. And... So we're just going to the west side of Highmountain now. Then we're going to do the lay race, which is just across the bridge to my right. Go, kitty. Giddy up, kitty. See, so that particular point wasn't on the path, it was just off the path. And if you're following the path, when you see it, you're going to miss it because it's slightly uphill and there's like trees and foliage in the way. So you gotta kind of watch where these spawn. The majority spawn along the road, but some of them do not. Like this one. And this will send you right off the cliff. Almost missed it. As usual with the lay race mount, you can't slow down or stop the mount. It runs forward on its own. Oh, I missed one. Hey, did that work? Didn't sound like it worked. You can't be attacked while you're on the mount either, so that's a refreshing change. Are there any other ones over here? Yes, there is. I don't normally go this far, but I missed a couple. So there we go, that is done. Alright, so now... Oh, why am I flying? The nearest flight point's at this tower right ahead of me. And then we're gonna go to Skyhorn. We're going to help Stonehoof improve their defenses. And then we'll head up into the mountain. I think we'll have time to head up in the mountain and do the remaining two up here.
Greetings, traveler. Together.
Greetings, traveler. Together we are Highmountain. This, of course, to my right is Thunder Totem, the capital of the High Mountain Tribes. Pretty cool. I wish they had designed the Tauren city like that, home city of the Tauren, in the core game. Or similar, not the same design, but, you know, update the graphics of the cities. All the cities need a refurbish, really. Even the Draenei and the Blood Elves. Blood Elf City is holding up pretty well.
Border defenses. But... our forces are stretched too thin. Can you help?
Somebody's already been through here killing guys.
It is.
Forces of Stormheim that are trying to infiltrate Highmountain, and this is right on the border. Like, we're right on the border with Stormheim on the east, southeast side. So it makes sense that there's like an invasion force.
That should remind those Vrykul that High Mountain is no easy summit to take.
That's true. Alright, so next, we're going to... Barrels of Fun, really? I guess I could do Barrels of Fun. I'll take the flight point up there.
Do you feel the change in the wind? Ride the winds.
So now we're going to the Ironhorn Conclave, which is just up the mountain here. So this is just like a little, I don't know, I guess it's a valley. It's really small, but it's a little valley in the mountains. And there's a miner here and a couple of other NPCs.
Here there.
Okay, let's see if I could do this. I'm recording this very early in the morning, so I'm still kind of sleepy, and this requires quite a bit of concentration. I'm not sure I can manage it. But we shall see. Oh god, don't tell me this is gonna go up to 7. I lost it there for a sec, so I'm not sure if I have the right container. Yep, I knew it. The first time I did this, it took me a half hour. It just kept going. Oh, I lost it there for a sec. I hope I still have the right one. Nope. I try not to blink while I'm doing this either. Because if you blink while they're shuffling, you're screwed, especially if they cross over each other in a similar direction. Alright, so now we've just got... Wow, I haven't done this one in forever. This is purging the kobold nest. It's been a long time. I'd easily say it's been probably 2 months since I've done this one. Been a pretty long while. I do have to go. That was way too close. Okay, this is gonna suck. I know I'm gonna probably die. Hey, not too bad. I'm surviving it. Yeah, I took some damage, but not a big deal.
My Pathfinders report a nest of kobolds taking up residence in the Echoing Hall.
Hello there, little kobold.
Oh,
I always refer to these kobolds as the candle-obsessed ones. They are, like, you do quests in Highmountain, and they're like, they follow the Candle King. And these guys kind of carry that theme from the Candle King. Too heavy, lift more. Too bad, almost at 60%, and I'm just in the first tunnel.
I am out of range.
Candles are done. Well, not really. I can just get more of them. Keep forgetting it's 100% quest, not a individual item quest.
Kobolds cause a tremendous amount of damage with their sloppy mining techniques. That high up, they could bring a chunk of that mountain down on top of us in no time. Well done rooting them out.
And now you find out right there why we're doing this, that they mine too aggressively and the whole mountain will collapse. And
if you like this video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.